大家好，我是 Eddie， 欢迎来到你好汉语。Hi guys, this is Eddie. Welcome to Nihao Chinese and welcome to today's HSK course. In today's lesson, we will focus on one grammar point, and the grammar point is from HSK Level 4 textbook, Lesson 5. Let's get started. 我们开始吧。Today's grammar point is 再说再说再说再说 means talk about something later or save something for later. 再 literally means again. 说 means say or to talk. However, this is only one meaning of 再说 this phrase. We have another one coming later, but let's just focus on this meaning first. 再说 here, it means save something for later.And it can be used as a verb. Take the sentences on our book as examples. Let's look at the first example sentence.
现在的事做了再说，以后的事以后再说。现在的事做了再说，以后的事以后再说。
For present things, we can finish it first and save the others for later.For things in the future, let's talk about them in the future. That's a better translation or a translation easy to understand from an English speaker's perspective. Now, let's break down the sentence and analyze.
现在的
These three words together means present or current as an adjective.
是
means thing, stuff, or issue.So, literally, it would be present thing, current thing. So, in your eyes, this might not even like a short sentence yet. This just look like a language fragment, like pieces. You don't see a sentence structure, yeah? Because we're talking about spoken Chinese. In daily life, you can really talk like that. Now, next,
做,
this word means to do.
了,
that's an indicator for...present perfect tense or just simple past tense. Now here,
做了,
you can treat these two characters together as finished. When I say finished, you noticed ed, because we're talking about past tense.
做了
means finished. And here, the sentence wants to tell us, let us finish something first. If you finished, and then we can talk about something else. So,
做了再说
means finish something first, and then talk about other things later.
以后的事
These four characters means future things.
以后的
that's an adjective, means future.
事
means thing or stuff.
以后
means later or in the future.
再说
save for later or talk about that later. Let's try to read the whole sentence again.While you're reading it, please also think about the English translation.
现在的事做了再说，以后的事以后再说。
Sentence number two. That's actually a conversation. The first speaker.
你不是很喜欢那件大衣吗？怎么不买了呢？你不是很喜欢那件大衣吗？怎么不买了呢？
Don't you really like that coat? Why don't you buy it?
你
means you, that's a pronoun.
不是
These two characters actually is a sentence structure. It's a rhetorical question signal phrase. If you see 不是 together, it could be a rhetorical question. And here, I would like to translate it asDon't you or don't they, something like that. It really depends on your subject, you know. Here, the subject is you. Then I translate it as don't you. If you see someday in the future a sentence like
他不是
yada yada, and then you can translate it as doesn't he yada yada.
很
means really.
喜欢
like.
那件
That. Actually, that is a quantifier for clothes.
那件 大衣 coat.
Ma is a signal word for yes and no question. So let's try to read the whole sentence again.
你不是很喜欢那件大衣吗?
Don't you really like that coat?
怎么不买了呢?
Here, 怎么, these two words means why. Sometimes, 怎么 could also be translated as how, but it doesn't fit the context here, so you just translate it as why. Now, you might have a question. Can I say the sentence like,
为什么不买了呢?为什么不买了呢?
If you want to say the sentence in this way, it's also 100% right. It's perfect. Yeah, it's just a different way of saying the sentence. Now, let's get back.
怎么 means why.
不买 means don't buy.
了,
this word has two functions. Number one, you can use it in past tense, present perfect tense. Number two, you can even use it in future tense. So, as confusing as this word could be, I just suggest you try to remember the sentence just as a whole part. And then if you're still confused, you can try to make more sentences to fit in this structure.
呢
is a yes and no question signal word. So the translation of the sentence would be, why don't buy it? You don't see the subject here in the sentence because we don't need it, because the subject is obvious. Let's try to read it again.
怎么不买了呢?
Do you remember just now I said 了 here is quite difficult to understand the use, and I said you can, try to make more sentences to let yourself be used to it, right? Now I'm going to offer you another example.
怎么不吃了呢?怎么不吃了呢?
Why don't you eat now? How can you use the sentence? Probably we're at a dinner table now and we're eating food. Suddenly you stopped and I will ask you a question. Why don't you eat? And then I can say,
怎么不吃了呢?怎么不吃了呢?
And here, if you eliminate 了, this word, this sentence would really be strange. It's a weird sentence, so do not eliminate 了, this character. Now let's talk about the second speaker, speaker B.
我真的很喜欢,不过没我的号了,下次再说吧。我真的很喜欢。不过没我的号了,下次再说吧。
I really like it. However, they don't have my size. Let's wait and see next time, or let's save it for next time.
我
means I.
真的 means really.
很 is very.
喜欢
that's like.
我真的很喜欢
literally, I.Really, very like.
不过
however, or but.
没
that means don't have.
我的
means my.
号
that size.
不过没我的号了
literally, but doesn't have my size. Now, be careful here.没, this character actually here is a short version for 没有, because 没有, these two characters means don't have, because 有 means have, and 没 is an active indicator. You put 没 and 有 together, it is don't have or doesn't have. However, here the sentence is just trying to be lazy and be casual and be spoken Chinese, and then it eliminate 有, this character, then,It just writes 没, this character here.
号
means size. However, from my perspective, I am a native speaker. The first word comes to my mind when I speak, it's not 号, this word, to mean size. It is actually
码子, 码子.
Well, of course, people from different parts in China would say, differently. But for me, if I want to mention size, Enclosed. Okay, I'm not talking about the size of a drink, like large Coke or small coffee, something like that. No, I'm just specifically talk about close size. I would say 码子, okay? But if you want to talk about drink or, you know, coffee, that's going to be a different case, yeah? So I'm going to read my version here. Listen carefully. 不过没我的码子了。That sounds more colloquial from my perspective as a person from, you know, southern China.
下次再说吧。
Talk about it next time. 下次 means next time.
再说,
save it for later, or talk about something later. 把, this character is a suggestion or advice signal word. You usually put 把 at the end of your sentence. And in English, a good translation for this character is let's. Let's do something. That's why I translate the sentence as let's save it for next time. Got it? Now let's read the whole conversation by speaker A and speaker B again. You can try to shadow read with me. Ready?
你不是很喜欢那件大衣吗? 怎么不买了呢? 我真的很喜欢, 不过没我的号了, 下次再说吧。
Now here comes the second use of 再说, this phrase, and here it means conjunction. The function is conjunction, and the translation would be besides, what's more, in addition, moreover, etc. And here we have two example sentences. Let's look at sentence number 3 first.
今天买的东西太多了。再说, 这个月家里已经花了5000多了。今天买的东西太多了。再说, 这个月家里已经花了5000多了。
Today, we shopped for so many things. Besides, this month, we have already spent over 5,000 RMB at home, for our home.
今天
means today. 买 means to buy. 买的, actually, if you see 的, this character, you immediately know that it's an indicator for an adjective or obsession. But here, definitely adjective, because 买的, these two characters together, describes 东西, describes the following phrase, 东西. 东西 means things or stuff. So 买的东西, together, it means stuff that we bought. Stuff we bought. It's kind of like a clause kind of thing.
太多
means too much or too many. Of course, here's too many because things are countable.
太多了.
Yeah, these three characters means too many or too much. Literal translation here for the sentence would be, today, the things we bought are too many. I hope by this way, my literal translation will help with your understanding, hopefully. Now, let's move on.
再说,
now it's very obvious this speaker hasn't finished his or her points, so he or she wants to explain furthermore. That's why you see this phrase,
再说.
Besides,
这个月
means this month,
家里
means in home or at home. That's just the literal translation, because 家 means home,
里
means in or inside. However, a better English translation here is for home, because they spend more than 5,000 yuan for their family. Okay, so it's not at or in. You need to be flexible. You need to be smart with your translation.
已经
means already.
花
means spend. That's a verb. Now be careful. 花 could also be a noun. What does it mean? It means a flower. But here, it ain't a flower. It is to spend. And 花 le, these two characters together, that indicates past tense. This action has finished. So 花了 together means spent. That's past tense. 五千 that's a number, 5,000. 多 means over or above. 五千多 over 5,000. Let's try to read the sentence again. 今天买的东西太多了。再说这个月家里已经花了五千多了。Sentence number four. Speaker A. 你飞机几点的？怎么还不准备？ What time is your flight? Why don't you get prepared already? 你 means you or your. Now, according to the context, here it means your. Because 你飞机 means your airplane.Literally, but that would be funny if you say your airplane, you say your flight, okay? 几点 means what time. 几 means how many or how much. 点 means point. How many point, literal translation. 几点 means what time. 你飞机几点的? What time is your flight? However, here you can also eliminate的, this character. It's not really important if you want to say 你飞机几点? That's also, you know, perfect. That makes sense. 怎么还不准备? Why don't get prepared already? 怎么? Do you remember these two characters? I said it has two meanings. 怎么 means how. Other meaning, why. Here is why. 还 means yet or already.不准备 don't get prepared or don't get ready. Why don't you get prepared already? 怎么还不准备? Speaker B. 晚上八点的,不着急。再说,我就去几天,不用带多少东西。It's 8 p.m. No need to rush.Besides, I only go there for a couple of days. There's no need to bring many things. 晚上 means evening or night. 八点 means 8 o'clock. 不用 means no need. 急 means rush or to hurry. 不用急 no need to rush, no need to hurry. That's, I actually think you can treat this three words as a fixed phrase. That would save a lot of your brain. You don't need to think hard. This is a phrase. 再说 means besides. 我 that's I. 就去就 here indicates only or merely or just. 去几天 go for a few days. 去 that's go. 几天 a couple days, a few days.几 literally means how many or how much, but here it means a few. 不用带 no need to bring. Do you see that? 不用 actually means no need to, and you can actually follow another verb after 不用. So the sentence structure is 不用 plus verb means no need to do. 不用带 no need to bring. 多少 means many. Actually, 多少 has multiple meanings. 多少 means how many or how much, but here it just means many. 东西 means things or stuff. 不用带多少东西. No need to bring too many things. Let's try to read the conversation again. You can shadow read with me. 你飞机几点的?怎么还不准备?晚上八点的，不用急。再说，我就去几天，不用带多少东西。Alright guys, that's all for today's content, and you know the drill, we always give you some practice to do after the lesson. Now here you can look at this page, we have 3 unfinished sentences, and that's your business to fill up the blanks with the most perfect answer. But of course, it is open-ended, so just use your imagination and what you learn to, you know, do the exercise and kill it. Alright, if you like today's lesson, don't forget to subscribe Eddie's channel and make sure to turn on that alert button to never miss a single video from Eddie G. 今天的课就到这里结束了，我们下期见，拜拜。